research. Research is important, especially when you're trying to move into a category called counterfactuals. Counterfactuals is a simple notion. Take the credit crisis. I personally think we did too much. And we can go back and do research and try to create modeling with econometric models that would mimic the economy under a variety of changing conditions and hypotheses. Not an easy task. There's another form of counterfactual that's being worked on right now. We just received a new paper from the San Francisco Fed, and it's entitled, Negative Rates Would Have Sped Up the Economic Recovery. You know, when it comes to low interest rates, I think that there's big counterfactuals as to how helpful they were during the credit crisis. Not only the fact that they were 0 to 25 for so long, too long in my opinion, but the notion of misallocating of capital, business zombies, businesses that were able to get financing that probably shouldn't have existed. And it's very hard to quantify and go back and create the type of program that would give you anything on the output side that is reasonable. But this paper really tries to paint a picture that negative rates, A, would have helped by creating higher inflation. And the logic goes something like this. They said that if you had to pay a bank to hold your money, that your next move is basically going to be to go buy something. Now, I ask you out there, maybe I'm just cynical, but if I was told that interest rates are negative and my funds are going to have a charge to be put in an institution, I don't know that spending is going to be the first thing on my mind. I think buying a shovel and looking in the backyard might be higher in my mental priority, actually. And I'm very happy. I'm not alone in this thinking. See, here's the problem. New research, especially when it comes from central bank, regional central banks, and I'm not saying they shouldn't do research, but putting a positive spin on negative rates to me is making me nervous, because is that just going to make this a tool for future use? But University of Chicago's Booth School of Business almost the next day also put out a paper. And guess what? They brought up the same issues I did, that negative interest rates are good in the beginning for a while. Small companies like them, but the big companies use them more, which creates a concentration, lack of competition, and finally, the money ball, lower productivity. Productivity is the silver bullet. I think that this research is important, but I also think it's important to keep the notion active. Negative interest rates should have no place for future use as a hammer in the Fed's toolbox. Just my opinion, and maybe Chicago's Booth School of Business.